Seven Cross by Herbert L. Clarke is a typical example of hundreds and hundreds, if not thousands, of pieces that were written for the cornet in the late 1800s and early 1900s. I was reading my International Trumpet Guild Journal in the last issue, and I happened to notice in one of the articles that in 1911 there were 603 cornetists registered in the New York City Musicians Association and zero trumpeters. Also, I happen to have a photocopy of a letter to Herbert L. Clarke, the person who wrote this piece of music, sent to Elvin Bench, who is known now as an instrument manufacturer. This was in 1921, and Mr. Bench was wanting Herbert L. Clarke's advice on whether or not he should switch from the cornet to the trumpet. And this is, at least in part, what Clarke had to say. Said that the trumpet is only a foreign fad for the time present. And that he had never heard a real soloist playing before the public on a trumpet, and that one cannot play a decent song properly upon it. And that it just sprang up like jazz music did. And goes on and on, but it's very obvious that he did not compare to the trumpet. These pieces to which I'm referring are not generally good from a musical standpoint, most of them. But nonetheless, this is an era in the history of the trumpet and cornet that's extremely important. And so that's one reason why I'm performing this piece, and probably one reason why these pieces will always be performed. But they were written basically for two reasons. There was many, many cornet players and not much literature. And then the other reason, which I think is perhaps a little more interesting, is that it was the cornet virtuosos who wrote these, and they were wanting to write things that made them sound good, and what better way to make yourself sound good than to write your own piece and put in it everything that you spent a lifetime perfecting. Of course, that makes it rough when people like me come along with that thing. I might add that I have not owned a cornet since I was a junior in high school. And I thought, well, you know, it would be interesting to play this on a cornet, but I didn't have one, except that I remembered that when I was in Enid a couple of months ago, I went to a flea market. I think it was an antique mall, to tell the truth. And I saw this one in a booth for sale. It was marked $15, and I thought, gosh, you know, it doesn't look too bad. I'll just buy it and give it to some kid that wants to join the band, can't afford to buy his own instrument. But it was still floating around the house when I was thinking about playing this piece, so I got it out and cleaned it up, and it played pretty good. It's a Holton, and I don't know enough about Holtons to know if this is a student model or a professional model. It's probably a student model. But anyhow, I don't know if I told you, but the price on this was $15. And when I got up to pay for it, they said, oh, that bid is having a 50% off sale. But even more interestingly, I thought, well, you know, if I play that, I'm going to have to sink about $23 into a Bach 1.5 mouthpiece. Because the mouthpieces are not interchangeable between the cornet and trumpet. And so when I had the thing out cleaning it up, I noticed, by golly, it had a Bach 1.5. So anyhow, I thought, I can't go wrong, because if I play real well, I'd say, now see what a bargain I got? And if I louse it up, I'd say, well, what do you expect for something? Here's the Schlabaugh, written in 1912 by Clarke.